Welcome to the first game for the 2015 B Football Rockets. The Rockets are in Lexington, home of the Minutemen, or as the Pop Warner Lexington team calls themselves, the Raiders. And it's the start of their inaugural season in Division III this year for Pop Warner. The move to the new division was facilitated mainly in part to some new weight limits instituted by Pop Warner nationally. And in short, those limits are going to go up. And the move to D3 was meant solely for competitiveness purposes. You know, one thing you notice right off the bat is the sheer size, and I mean size meaning number of players of Reading versus Lexington here. I am joined on camera by Brian Van Horn, legendary BVH, the man who single-handedly was responsible for RCTV adding a seven-second delay to their Pop Warner productions. I kid you, BVH, we knew that was really Jimmy Yandel who did it. But I'll just say this, you always bring your A game to the B game, you know what I'm saying? Unfortunately, your A game is a lot like most people's D game. So, all right, hey, we'll be back shortly for the kickoff coming up. Reading captains Troy Pollock, Dan O'Connor, and Dan Damari out there to get the toss. Listen, I don't want to say I greased any palms for my son being come captain. He was voted by his teammates, but never underestimate the power of 33 Zynga gift cards stuffed in someone's backpack. You know, so, but Oki, Troy Pollock and Dan Damari are this year's captains, and we'll just come up. The toss is coming up right now. Reading's won the kickoff, and back deep are Dan Damari and Reading Pop Warner newcomer Dante Barbosa. He's a heck of an athlete. Nice boot right to Barbosa. Picks it up, trying to follow a block of Damari. He cuts back, and he's got a little bit of room ahead of him. He's got some wheels, too. Dante puts his head down, gets it back all the way, almost to midfield. So the Rockets are going to start off first and 10 with excellent field position on the 46. Looks like number 24, probably the biggest player in the Rockets, Lucas Fleming, in at quarterback right now. Shotgun, it's a keeper right behind. Looks like, oh boy, is he a bull, huh? He just bulls out for about 11 yards, follows Sean Beckenhues. And I'll tell you, Fleming's going to be a handful for any of these guys all day. He runs in close to 150 pounds, and the limit being 155, he's a big player. You know, just looking at this thing, Brian, there's literally twice as many Reading players here, and that might be the toughest test for the coaches here is, how do I get them all in? Breaks the huddle, Fleming in the shotgun again, flanked by Beckenhues. Looks like Jeremy Rosh right. Ooh, nice bull rush again by Fleming. Looks like a little bit of a face mask on that one, but he gains another 4 yards. Dan Damari back in at quarterback right now. It's a keeper left, he follows Beckenhues. Big hole! Damari cuts left, and he's very close to the first down with the Rockets moving at will early on here in this first series. All right, here we go, second and one here for the Rockets. Troy Pollock in at quarterback. That's an inside handoff, number 11, Jeremy Rosh. He's got nothing but daylight ahead of him. Oh, what a straight arm! Rosh puts a straight arm, gets another 4 or 5 yards. So, listen, in the this is what we talked about earlier, Brian. The Rockets have 8 or 9 guys who can run. They've run 3 different quarterbacks in the first set, and we've had about 3 or 4 different guys carry the ball, all for big gains, and it's going to be first and goal for Reading. Troy Pollock in. He's a keeper himself to the right. Ooh, Troy gets met up, gets wrapped up. He's a tough guy to bring down, and gets wrapped up, pushed back for a couple yards. Looks like it's going to be second and goal from about the 6. In comes the big boy Fleming back in at quarterback. Flanked by Beckenhues left. Oh, tough snap. He picks it up. Lucas still gets a few yards, but the muff snap cost him because if he caught it, he had a big open seam there and he wasn't about to be stopped. So we're looking at third and goal here now. The Rockets move stalling a little bit here to start. Rockets bringing some big bodies in on the line. 53, Steve Needham, Adam Deemer, 64, and big Anthony Masucci. Pollock hands it off to Fleming. He bulls in. Oh, runs over 3. Lexington guys, and what a great start for the Rockets, huh, Bri?
Definitely.
Bunch of different, you know, mixing it up. I said, you know, we said earlier, maybe the biggest thing that's going to be a problem with the coaching staff is getting these guys some play, but that's a lot of different guys who can do some work offensively. And Lucas Fleming, the big man, bowls in for the first touchdown of the season for the Rockets. Here we are, Jeremy Rosh trying for the extra point. My protege, we did some kicking drills and with him here. Let's see how it goes. Yes, it's in. Beautiful. I'm going to pat myself on the back for that one as I handle the kicking clinic for these guys. And Jeremy, very first one of the year. And that's a huge play here at this level because a kick is 2 points. And that's the difference between teams that move on in the playoffs and the ones who don't. So I don't know if you've noticed, BVH, I got my Barry White voice going on right now.
Yeah.
You know, the old, yeah, like I waked up way too early even though it's midday. So that's what happens. Sounding great, don't you think?
Oh, yeah.
All right, we'll come back to the action with the Rockets ready to kick off. Lucas Fleming to kick off. Let's see if things change this year for Bob Junta-led Rockets. He loves to squib these things, send his speed guys after, but he does kick it away. Field of the 32. He's met immediately, looks like by number, maybe it's number 7, Troy Pollock. Some speed on the outside, and Troy's not the biggest guy, but he's perfectly happy to mix it up with anybody, and he lays them out about the 38, so we're going to see Lexington for the first offensive series. You know, Lexington's got about 16 guys here, Brian, I go. That's not too many substitutes. These guys are going to be on the field all day, and the Rocket depth may be one of those things that could wear them down over time, so. First and 10 here for Lexington. Big, big D-line set up. Watch Fleming over the center. Oh, boy. Wow, nice play there. And I don't know if you watched, keyed in on our boy Fleming. Absolutely blew up the center there. They got some big bodies on that line, starting with 44 Danny Junta. Left, number 40, Matt Sagala. Fleming over the nose. Danny O'Connor on the right and Keith Richmond. That's a couple of big boys against this line, and they're going to try to set a message. Cueing on Fleming again. I think their center didn't know what hit him. It's going to be a pitch left. Got a little bit of room. Gets around the outside. Nice play there. Patrick Harrigan forces him out around the 45, so nice play by number 42 to get outside of, look like Beckenhuis, and pick up a good gain there. So it's going to be second and looks like 3. Big third down here for the Rockets from the Lexington 45. I formation. It's a handoff, number 42 up the middle. Oh, Fleming absolutely crunches him. Gets a little bit of help. Piled on, I'll see if I can get that other number. Number 22 was Danny Damari in there. Fleming and Damari put the Malachi crunch on him, and it's fourth down. And at this level, we'll see if it's, you know, it's a lot of times it's four down territory, but that Rocket front D is, that's a tough one. Fourth and call it a very long two and a half here. Dante Barboza split left. It's a pitch. Number 12, in comes Barboza, and there he is. Picked him out, and Barboza wraps him up, huh? Nostradamus out here, Brian. Saw him split. Beautiful play by Dante. I tell you, Dante moved to town a couple years ago. He played on my baseball team for a year. It's like Kelly Leak coming in for the Bad News Bears. Just a cool dude, super baseball player, great athlete. And this is his first year playing this year, and already made his impact felt with a big kickoff return and a great play at fourth down. And this is going to give the Rockets a short field. All right, looks like we have yet another quarterback in. Patrick Harrigan. Damari. Split right. Looks like we have some movements going to push the Rockets back 5 yards. We're going to do it again. First and 15 here for the Rockets. Harrigan at quarterback, Damari and Matt Sagala stacked right. He's going to follow Sagala. It's a pitch out to Damari, and it's actually a fumble. to Danny's credit, he just does the right thing and hops in the ball and tries not to advance it forward. So looked like a little bit of a poor pitch, and there's going to be tough conditions out there. I said we're on a grass field here today, Brian, in a really rainy conditions. I think the town of Lexington may be the last town in North America that doesn't have a turf field. maybe the per household income isn't high enough over here to get a turf field, but but the conditions, the field's actually in very good shape considering the weather right now. But that ball's going to be tough to handle all day. And here we go. It's now moving the other direction, second about 20. On the center is Harrigan. He hands it off left to Damari. Huge hole! Oh, Danny. Hey, Danny could have gone left for a big gain. He decides to put his shoulder down and send a message. And he gets 10 back quick. So great run by Damari. But we're looking at a third and 10 or 11 coming up. Harrigan at quarterback. Matt Sagala behind him. Inside, oh, it's going to be a pass. Beautifully set up play, and it goes out to Dante. And Barbosa's still up. Whoa! Huge play. I think he's very close, if not right at the first down. But Dante breaks a tackle. He's got some runaway speed, too, and very, very fortunately gets tripped up because he had nothing but daylight ahead of him. And that's a huge play on third down. Beautifully set up pass. Inside fake to Sagala. Rolls right, Harrigan, and he throws it out to Dante, wide open. First and 10 here for the Rockets. Andrew Fortino at center. Shotgun to Harrigan. Back to Harrigan, he's gonna follow Damari. Huge hole up there. Patrick puts his head down and gets an easy five, and the wind is blowing us away up here, Brian. I almost got carried out of here. Good thing I weigh about, what do I weigh, huh? Probably 225 pounds. Solid steel, right, Brian? Oh, yeah. Yeah, maybe not. All right, hey, it's going to be second and five upcoming. All right, we have second and five here. Harrigan in the shotgun. Inside handoff to Barbosa. He's got a little bit of room. Dante cuts left, gets around there. Nice hit. Oh, he's still on his feet. Tough guy to bring down, but he gets the first down. It's going to be first and inside the red zone here. First and 10 for the Rockets, right about the 20-yard line. I'll tell you why we're taking a little bit of time to switch for the quarter there. I wanted to mention, Brian, we got to see a couple of preseason games, and one of the biggest hits of the actual preseason took place in the Chelmsford scrimmage. A little bit of a scuffle between Beck and Houston, a Chelmsford player, and in came big Dan Damari to break it up. Well, the momentum he had came in, and he bumped into that Chelmsford player and knocked him about 15 yards. I go, that was easily the biggest hit of the preseason by Coach Damari. Not a small man. There's a thing called inertia, right, Bry? You know how I like to drop knowledge, right? Yeah. It's when something's in motion, tends to stay in motion. Well, Damari could not stop himself and leveled a 12-year-old child. All right, here we go. It looks like we're right back to the action here. We'll come back in a sec. First and 10, from the 20. Hand off to Damari. Beautiful play by number, it looks like 28 or 21. Who snuffs it out and takes Damari down for a loss or maybe just back to the original line of scrimmage. So nice defensive play by Lexington. It's going to be second and 10 now. Harrigan under center. Damari and Sagala behind him. Inside. Oh, it's a sweep to Jeremy Ross. Jeremy gets outside. He's being pursued, but Jeremy puts his head down and gets about five. So we're going to be looking at third and five from the 15. Another nicely set up play, but give credit to Lexington. They didn't bite on it. And Jeremy did get around one defender for five, but we got third and five coming up. Third and five for the Rockets. Troy Pollock in there at quarterback now. This is going to be a tough year for me, Bry. Seven quarterbacks, 22 running backs. Here's Pollock. It's a keeper. It's a pitch. Oh, to Fleming, and he drops the ball. Oh, it's the ball's in the ground, and Lexington gets it. Hits Fleming off the cage, bounces. It looks like Fleming was in there, and the Rockets turn the ball over. So these are the types of things that keeps games close. You know, just when you're about to put your foot on the gas here, the ball turns over, and Lexington's going to take over first and 10. So fortunate events for Lexington, and we're going to see their second series upcoming. First and 10 from Lexington from their own 18-yard line. A little diminutive quarterback there, number 12. It's a handoff up the middle. Oh, good pursuit, but he breaks away. Good, nice job breaking away. He's still going to take a loss, but who was in there deep? It was 22, I think it was Damari. Just fired through a hole and was on top of him right when he handed the ball off. So credit the big offensive line there too. Fleming, O'Connor, and Richmond. Those guys are blowing these guys off the line. So it's going to be second and looks like 13 now. Single back. Oh, the ball goes on the ground. Good job by the quarterback from Lexington just to hop on it. So it's going to be third down and 13 here. And once again, the conditions probably playing going into play here with the wet balls. Third and 13. Lexington going the other way in this series. Deep in their own territory. This is a big play for them. It's going to be a pass. Goes back. Oh, boy. Junta almost had him in the backfield. Now it's a run. Jeremy Ross cuts in there. Good play to extend it out. He doesn't get anywhere when all's said and done. Danny Junta was all over him. Good job by the quarterback to escape him, but gets it back to the original line of scrimmage. It's fourth and maybe one here, but this is a tough call deep in the territory if you want to kick this thing or try to get a few yards. They haven't gained any positive yardage on this series yet. Looks like they will be attempting a kick here. Oh, does kick it. Nice play by Pollock to catch it. Oh, good move to escape him too. Oh, there's going to be a flag, a hit from behind, unfortunately. And I think that was Barboza, or either Barboza or 41, and he was trying to help out Troy, who did a couple of jukes there. And the Rockets are going to take over, but a hit from behind is going to move them back another 15 yards to start, so they'll probably be on their side of the field. The penalty is going to push the Rockets into their territory, first and 10 from their 47. Troy Pollock, who made a great play catching the ball, athletic escape move, fortunately gets penalized here. Inside handoff to Fleming. Good move by number 12. I think that's their quarterback to wrap up Fleming's legs because you're certainly not going to take him down from above the waist. And it's a no gain. All right, here we go. It's going to be second and 11. They actually lost a yard there with Fleming, which you're not going to hear that too often this year. Might be a first and a last. Looks like we have Pollock in the backfield in the shotgun. It's a keeper. He's going to run behind Fleming. He gets around the outside, and Troy's got room. Nice job. Good run. Sneaks out at about, you know, we're going to get to about a 10-yard gain there. May call it nine. It's going to be third and short here in Lexington territory. Yeah. All right, it's third and short here for the Rockets. Under center is Pollock again. Fleming in the backfield with Sagala. It's a handoff to Fleming. Oh, boy, he pulls it up, and he gets the first down easily over the 40-yard line of Lexington. And that's the type of running we're used to seeing Lucas do, and tough guy to bring down. I think on that last play, the big run by Pollock, might have had a nice little block. We're going to check the film on that for one number 42, Derek Van Horn, cameraman's son. We're gonna pump the tires of our boys all years because that's what we do for volunteering. So here we go. It's going to be first and 10 here. 38-yard line. Pollock, interesting setup here with Fleming split left, and he's in motion. Oh, it's a high one. Oh, it's a keeper. Nice move there. They went with Fleming, and Troy Pollock, nice deke moves and gets about another eight. So, nicely set up play. Good move by Pollock to make that catch. He had to go up high for that one. Fake to Fleming, who was in motion, and that keeper rips it off for eight. So, nicely set up play. Troy under center right now, Fleming and Beckenhuis. Inside handoff to Fleming again. Ooh, bulls down again. That's going to be very close to the first down. Let's see if they give it to him. If he isn't, he's going to be inches away. So looks like third and very short coming up. They're going to give him the first. So it's a first down for the Rockets at about the 27-yard line. Here we go. First and 10 for the Rockets. Under center is Pollock. It's a fake handoff. Pollock's going to throw. It's the same setup play that was effective with Barboza last time. Just swung it a little bit right here. Jeremy Ross was open. Give credit to number 84. Lexington was sticking with him, but just an errant pass to the right on that one. Out of the huddle, they don't want to let this short-staffed Lexington team get any breathers. Pollock under center. Hand off to Fleming left. Oh, the big man. Ooh, good job. He bounces off one guy, bounces off another. Fleming looking like Gronkowski the other day. Is wide open. Not one guy's going to take him down. So that's going to be gain of about six or seven right there. So let's call it third and three. This is where the Rockets were last time with the unfortunate fumble. So once again inside the red zone, Pollock under center. Beck and Houston Fleming, backfield. Hand off to Fleming. Oh, he cuts up the middle and Lucas just rips that one off for a quick 10 yards too. Nice cutback by the big guy. He moves very, very well out there. And he's got to be an imposing guy, especially when he gets in the defensive backfield. Those little guys see him coming, they think it's Earl Campbell. First and goal here for the Rockets. Couple of big bodies on the line. Masucci, Deemer, Hattery. Oh, it's up over Pollock's head. Give him credit. Troy does a nice job. That ball was bouncing around and number 28 was all over him. Bad snap is going to move the Rockets back, and this is what we ran into last time, Brian. We get some positive yardage, and Coach Junta's seen enough. He's mixing up the whole offense right here. A luxury to have when you have 34 kids on your team. Second and goal from the 21. We don't call that often. Harrigan back with Dan Damari. Split left is Barboza. It's going to be a pass. Oh, good. What a nice job by Patrick to evade it and then put his head down to get a few yards. But there's big pressure from Lexington there. It was going to be a pass either out to Sagala or Barboza. And Patrick had to pull it down and get himself 5 yards, maybe a couple. It's going to be, looks like, third and goal from the 20. All right, here we go. Third and very long goal here. Harrigan in the center. Damari, looks maybe Sagala or Barboza in the backfield. Hand off to Damari. Oh, beautiful play up the middle. Number 28, I'll tell you, he called his number a couple of times for Lexington. He's made a couple of big athletic plays getting through that line, and he drops it to fourth down. You're probably going to see him go for it here. That's way too long for a kick and probably too short for a punt. So look for some type of play here for the Rockets to at least get some positive yardage and pin Lexington deep. All right, not too many plays in the playbook. Fourth and 22, or should we say fourth and goal. So the Rockets either get in the end zone here or they turn the ball over. It's going to be a pass. Good. Oh, my gosh. Harrigan evades number 28, throws it deep. Not quite enough to reach Barboza, who was well covered as well, but Harrigan did everything he can. Number 28 in there again. Huge pressure on the line. And turned the ball over and actually turned the ball over, giving Lexington better field position than they had when they started the drive. So that's two drives in a row that the Rockets have got down to the red zone and things have stalled out. So credit Lexington for some great pressure up the middle, though. 10 for Lexington from their own 22-yard line. Interesting formation here. Two in the back, two split right. It's a pitch. Oh, nice pursuit by Damari. He goes in there, and then it's picked up. Let's see who got him there in the end. Number 43, Barboza, cleans him up. Big hit by Barboza, but once again, you see number 22, Damari, shooting a gap there and putting a lot of pressure on that, even with three blockers on him. So it's going to be second and call it 8. And trying to move quickly here. I think they're they got some motion going on. They're going to move them back 5 yards. I think they might have been running. I don't know if they were calling if it was a play clock move or they're trying to hurry up there. You heard the Lexington guys say, go, go, go. Let's see who this one's against. Yeah. Motion on Lexington. It's going to move him back in the shotgun number 12. Oh, sorry, not back. 12 is behind the quarterback. Oh, it's going to be a pass here. He fires it out, lays it out. Oh, boy, that's going to be a penalty, unfortunately, on Damari because he didn't turn around. So nicely set up play, good coverage, but if you don't turn that head around, they're going to call it every time. So Damari will take a penalty. That's going to be a first down for Lexington. They're probably their biggest play from scrimmage, a penalty. Getting very close to halftime here. I think they move it 15 yards automatic at this level. It's not a spot foul. Ball's on the ground. Quarterback jumps on it. So a couple of different times, handoffs on both sides where the ball has been a little too slippery for the boys out there. As we get ready for the second half, that's our friend Joe Gilligan. He's the director of football for Pop Warner. He's a good dude, but I was just thinking, me and Brian were talking offline that Joe looks like the commissioner of every cop show that was ever made, right? You know, maybe a gruff exterior, and then you crack them open, and it's soft and creamy and sweet, like Big Teddy Bear, Joe Gilligan. So Joe's been running, doing a great job as the director of football here, and basically passing off all my social duties to Joe, too, the Reading Social coming up now. So we're going to have Lucas Fleming ready to kick off for the second half with the Rockets up 8-0, and it's a lot closer than it should be right now with the Rockets two drives stalling. Fleming's back to kick. Big boot by Fleming. Kicks it down to the 20. Fielded nicely by number 42 here. He's asking for a couple of blocks, and he gets met by number 51 right there. With 35 guys in there. That's Zach Kenyon in there. Nice job by Zach. I said, I'll never remember all these names. 34 guys on the team, but great job by Kenyon. It's going to be first and 10 for Lexington from the 32. Lexington taking a little extra long time, breaking the huddle. Looks like he was mapping it out in his hand like it's on the sand lot. Two guys split right, one back. It's going to be a throw right. Oh, boy. Oh, nice play to avoid what was, looks like Sagala, and he's going to run for a big gain there. So huge pressure by Matt Sagala in there, what looked like a loss, and credit to number 12, the quarterback. He had two guys going deep. He was going to pass to him, and it actually left him a huge lane to run in, and it's a first down for Lexington. And here we go. Here, big coach Dan Beckin, who's employing Sagala to wrap him up. First and 10. Stacked right formation. Now heavily stacked. One man in the backfield. It's a handoff up the, oh boy, hand up in the middle, and he drops it. Beckenhuis right in there, as well as number 43, Barboza. So that's going to move him back one. We're looking at second and 12. Lexington taking a lot of time in the huddles here. Two guys in the backfield. Quarterback under center, two split right. Oh, it's going to be a pitch, and it's a broken play. Dan Junta right in there. And nice move by the quarterback again, but then Damari comes in to clean it up. Danny Junta was in there. Huge pressure. And, you know, their quarterback looking a lot like Harrigan. There's big pressure there, and he's making some escape moves. That one's going to push him back even farther, but that was the pressure from Junta that created that. And Damari comes rocking him through a hole again to clean it up. So it's going to be third and long. All right, third and long here for Lexington. Spread formation, two in the back. Number 22 in motion. Oh, good move by the, oh, nice play. Look at the pursuit by Fleming. Wow, he got in there and got his hand on the ball. The Rockets did a nice job to actually get back. A couple of them jumped, and then they got back on and pushes it back, so it's fourth and forever here for Lexington. Fleming blowing up the center and getting his hand on the ball, knocked it loose, and lucky grab for Lexington. They're going to kick from here. Oh, it's a high snap. Wow, good play to get a kickoff, but they get nothing. Oh, fortunate bounce. Very fortunate for Lexington. That thing was about a 10-yard kick and got a 15-yard bounce to get it to midfield. So works out for Lexington to kick the ball away. Couldn't have been a better bounce for them. And the Rockets are going to take over with great field position on Lexington's side of the field. First and 10 Rockets. Pollock is going to be under center, or in the shotgun, as it were. Damari split right. Beckenhuis also there. Oh, we got movement along the line. The ball's not hiked, and they're going to move Redding back 5 yards. You know, we're up here up top, and the wind's blowing a little bit. And the old concession stand stuff is blowing right across our face here. And BVH letting me know that it smells fantastic, but you know, him having the munchies isn't exactly a surprise. There you go. First and what is now 15. Steve Needham centering. Right to Pollock. It looks like it's going to be a keeper. He pitches it out to Damari. There's nothing but daylight in front of him. Oh, Danny cuts back and dives for a few more. What a beautiful play. And Damari absolutely pounds this guy, and he's hurt. And hopefully he gets up, though. He's looking pretty good. So what a beautifully set up play. And that was made only possible because Pollock held on to that much longer. Looked like he was going to take the run himself. Dishes a beautiful pitch to Damari, who had 30 yards of grass in front of him, and it's going to be first and 10 from the 33-yard line. Pollock in the shotgun. Damari left. Beckenhuis, Barboza split left. He's going to follow these guys. Going to try it again. And they do it the exact same thing the other way. Beautiful play. Look at Damari. Wow. Athletic play just to get the pitch was a little behind him and rips it off for 15 yards. So, you know, they do it right. They do it left. Damari and Pollock connecting for some huge plays right there. Cred, the offensive line there, too, splitting out left. It's nice job for those lead blocks, which was Barboza on the left. It's first and goal here for the Rockets. Pollock in the center. It's a handoff to Damari up the middle. Damari just bulls his way in, and he's in for the touchdown. So great three runs by Danny Damari. Looking very shifty out there. And I'll tell you, the Rockets just keep rolling in waves. And as we talked about earlier, Brian, a couple of guys from Lexington going off with some injuries. These guys are getting pounded on. There's only 15 of them left on the roster. And that's the difference with the big, just rolling big numbers at you. And Lexington just not able to compete later in the game here. So let's see what the extra point is. We'll see if we're going to let Rosh kick again. Pollock is the holder. Rosh lines it up with the sight in his eyes. Oh, it's over his head. Pollock's going to take it himself, and he's going to get in there, I think. Nice deke move, and Pollock gets in on the broken play. That's just an athletic move by Troy. That play was not planned, just too high of a snap, and Troy takes it in for, I guess, what will be one now versus two. So with 4:02 in the third left, the Rockets 15, Lexington nothing. Coming back to kick. Great insight added by BVH here, saying they could be using composite balls in this weather. Field, he's down. So it's going to be, the composite balls tend to get slick here, and you made the point that maybe the leather balls with a little bit of wetness on them create a little bit more tackiness. So you're bringing your A game to the B game. Huh? You were right again. You know, we work with Jeremy on the kicking, and the key thing at this level, too, is it's one thing to get a guy to kick, but the execution of the snap and the hold are actually, you know, arguably even more difficult at this level. So that one, we benefit from having a great athlete like Troy Pollock in there to turn it into a point. So it's going to be first and 10 here for Lexington, and they're dropping players like flies here. That big Reading defensive line is back in. Watch Fleming in the middle over center. Oh, it's it. Hand off right, he gets strung out. Nice job to get around the corner, but looks like number 41 or number 11, Jeremy Rosh, does a nice job to pull him in. Good pursuit by a bunch of Rockets. It's gonna be second and 8 here. Good job by Lexington to make something out of nothing there. I formation, stack tight. It's a handoff right to the, what pursuit right there. Oh, and in comes Oki for the crunch. Nice job. I'll tell you, beautiful job by Junta, and I don't know who else got the lead in there. Pushed him back, and Oki comes in and cleans him up. And, you know, we talk about how big that line is. My boy Oki's pushing over 5'8 these days. I was 5'5 my sophomore year of high school. He's apparently on the Dan Damari, Dan Beckenhuis diet. He's aspiring to attain his formal goon squad status. But these guys are big. Great tackle by Oki there, but that was really done by, I think it was number 21, Richmond on the right, had the pursuit in. Oak cleans him up for a loss. It's going to be third and 12. You can see the size difference, Brian, on that line. These guys from Lexington are going to be seeing them in their nightmares. Stack left formation, It's going to be a pass. Oh, he sets it up. He didn't really let his receiver get out into the pattern, but Patrick Harrigan was in a perfect spot there. I think if he waited another second, Harrigan would have been, coverage would have been great. Pollock was behind him too, so it's fourth and long here for Lexington. Fourth and forever here for Lexington. Oh, they're going to punt again. Not a bad little kick. Oh, he's got a, number 51 was right there with Zach Kenyon. And that was sort of a tough play there. He dropped that ball. He was thinking about catching it and running. He had some room left, but at that stage, you might just want to let that ball drop. You're going to get the ball anyway. Don't get your hands on it when it's slick out there. So great defensive stop right there for Reading. And they're going to take over with, once again, excellent field position. The game's 15 to nothing. It feels like a lot more than that, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Fleming back in at quarterback. Has to be disheartening to the Lexington team. Split left, number 12, Dylan Lee. Oh, he follows Beckenhues. Boy, he is a bull. He's still on his feet. Fleming rips off 15 like it's nothing. Even with the Lexington players screaming, watch for the QB sneak. He keeps it, and they know the play that's coming. They still can't stop him. We team parent Laurie Masucci up here, and I don't know about you, BVH. What a treat. No one looks more fashionable in a rain gear than you. She's putting stuff in our pockets. I hope it's cash. Unfortunately, it looks like the picture forms. That's disappointing. What's that? Hold on for a sec. Oh, yo, that's how you go. Turn around backwards. There we go. Oh, sorry, Fleming's going to be left. Great pursuit there, and they stopped him. That's number 28 again. He's probably one of the top athletes on this team here, and he wasn't afraid to mix it up with Fleming for a short game. Get very distracted when Laurie Masucci comes up here to the booth. When, you know, she's effectively the female equivalent of me. She's beautiful, right? You know what I'm saying? So it's very often, not often you have two beautiful people up here with you, BVH, huh? How lucky for you. How lucky for you. Second down.
Gilligan up here with us.
Oh, yeah, we got Coach Gilligan up here? Forget it. Here we go. Pollock, inside handoff to Ross. There's all sorts of room in front of Jeremy. Jeremy tries to cut back, and they do a nice job holding him up. He might have wanted to go left on that one, but that's a beautiful, nice inside handoff. That's a good-looking play there. They've done it once before today. There's a lot of daylight in front of those guys, so it's going to be third and short here for the Rockets. All right, Rockets not wasting any time here. Fourth side of the fourth quarter here. It's third and short. Fleming, shotgun. It's a keeper right behind Beckenhues. He's got all sorts of room in front of him. Oh, Lucas just shredding. Oh, boy. Absolutely steamrolls number 42 at the end. He's got a little bit of room ahead of him and ahead of steam. That is going to be disheartening. Poor number 42 for Lexington saw a freight train coming down on him. Seconds later, he felt it going over him. Fleming. Wow. That guy, he could be playing on the A team right now. Missed here on that one, Brian, but they're actually replaying the down. I don't know if they said they went before the whistle. They snapped it before the ref blew the whistle. Gosh, poor number 42 back there might be seeing Fleming again. So the touchdown by Fleming's called back. Similar setup. Beckenhues in the backfield with him. He follows. Oh, same move again. Oh, the ball's on the ground, though. Wow. What a turn of events. Fleming gets stripped of the ball after the touchdown run. They call it back. And that's the second time we've done it down here. You know, one thing about Big Lucas is it's about where those arms are, too, when he's holding it. He's a big guy. And he gets stripped of the ball on that one. And here we go again, boys. Inside the 20. And like I said, a game that's 15 to nothing that seems like 40 to nothing. And letting Lexington hang around here. One or two plays and be a whole different ball game. Oh, it's first and 10 for Lexington from their 18. Handoff left, number 42. That was our guy. Oh, boy. Number 24, Lucas Fleming comes in and crushes him again. And it looks like he might have got a little face mask, too. Unfortunately, not Fleming, but someone before him. And I'll tell you, number 42, they said it was no play on the touchdown. Ask number 42 if it was a play. He got run over, and then Fleming came in and said no again. So got a piece of his face mask. They got to mark it off 15 yards. Like we said today, two of Lexington's biggest three plays have been on penalties. So it's going to be first and 10 here from the 33. Redding's got that big D line in there again. I formation. It's going to be a pitch out here. Nice pitch. He goes Dante. He's in there. He slows him up, and then in comes to clean it up is number 81. That's Cole Tully in there. Nice job for Cole to get the tackle, and it was Barboza's penetration that slowed him up. Tully makes the tackle and moves off of big number 70, Dave Lynch. Dave Doubt Me Lynch. And by doubt me, he says, don't doubt me. He's a real character, as is his dad, Dave Sr. I could tell you a bunch of stories about him, all of them unsuitable for Reading cable television. all of them. All right, here we go. Second and 9 right here. I formation, we got some guy split way left. Harrigan's on him. That's gonna be pitch. Oh, the ball's in the air. Wow, athletic play by number 22. That one looked like a play we haven't seen before. They just couldn't execute it. Too high of a pitch. Like to see these new wrinkles, these new plays, but that was a good play by number 22, just to hop on it. Because that could have been turning it right back to Redding's favor. So third and about 14 here for Lexington. Jonathan Grady, number 14, replaces Richmond on the big line there. Coach Junta mixing up a lot of the players at this point. Oh, it's going to be a pass play here, and he heaves it up. That's the same exact play. Wow, he catches it anyway. You know, same exact play that Damari had the flag on. There's going to be another flag here because he didn't turn around again. I don't know if that was Barboza. But once again, they'll call it face guarding there, which it won't matter. They're going to take the play. Beautiful catch right there by number 22. Heaved it up in the air, and I think those Rocket defensive backs or those corners, they just got to make that play to turn their head, right? If they're not turned around, they're going to call it every time, and that's another one for Lexington. Might have been after the fact. Looks like they called a penalty on Lexington after the fact. Personal foul moved him back after a huge gain. So it's first down. Foul had to come after the play. It's going to be a pass. He fires it up in the air. He's wide open. Beautiful play. And an excellent play by number 52 was Andrew Fatino. Timed it perfectly. But that kid was wide open. Fatino hit him right as the ball got there, so great play by Andrew there, and he was the last line of defense. If he doesn't make that play, that's a long one. That's what we were talking about, Brian. One or two plays here can make a 15-0 game very close when it shouldn't be. All right, here we go. It is second down and 10 after the incomplete pass. It's going to be another pass here. He fires it up. Oh, this one right here. Oh, Jeremy Rosh with the one hand. He was in good position. Once again, just as we're talking about, he's going to turn around. Jeremy does the job. Almost pulls it down with one hand, but that was a much trickier play there for Lexington because well defended by Rosh this time. Offensive line of Patrick Duross, big Dave Lynch, 81, Cole Tully, 65. Anthony Wasabi Masucci and Jonathan Grady out there now. It's a pitch left. He's got a little blocker ahead of him. Nice pursuit right there. Beautiful job by Rosh to come in and close it. Get some help from number 51, Zach Kenyon, and also DeRoss. So good game right there. Good looking play, but we're looking at fourth down here. Barboza, Kenyon, Rosh, Harrigan, linebackers. Actually, Barboza looks like he's playing corner here. I mean, safety. Well, the ball goes on the ground. He keeps it. Good job to pick it up and go forward. And he looks like he got the first down. So I think that might, I don't know if that was a design play. Looked like he dropped the ball, picked it up, and just dove forward. So as my buddy Fitzy down there. All right, first and 10 here for Lexington. We got about 3.5 minutes left in the game here. Trying to put something together and get on the board here. Great work on the camera lens by you with the timeout. Uh-oh. Number 28, that's the big athlete on that team. Jumps the wrong count, and then we're going to move the other way. Here we go. First and 15 here for Lexington after the penalty. From their own 36. Oh, another quick snap. He's going to roll out. He's looking for a block. He doesn't really get it. And he gets wrapped up right there. I think it was Kenyon in there, number 51, with the tackle. Nice job, nice pursuit by the Rockets. Masucci in there as well. So we're getting very close down here. But a little bit of asynchronicity is what we call it with the game clock and the real clock these days. But it looks like it's going to be a timeout here for Lexington. And 15 here for Lexington. Redding mixing up on defense. Oh, it's an inside handout. Number 22 takes the ball. He's got blockers ahead of him. Well set up play. Cuts back. Gets tripped up just by, oh, he's still on his feet. Oh, no, he's going to take it. Here comes Barboza. Can he take him down? Dante's trying to track him, and he does. Barboza catches him from behind at the 5. But beautiful run by 22. They couldn't wrap him up. Kenyon had him early, and he breaks it off with 2 minutes to go. Lexington trying to get on the board here. Here we go. It's first and goal here for Lexington. Under 2 minutes to go, and Coach Jones just shifts up the entire defense. Goes back to his big body defense. Got the lights dancing right in our way here, Bry. Oh, the ball is fumbled. Oh, it pops right into his hands. Number 44, Junta all over him. Fleming with a little bit of help. So almost a missed snap there, but very fortunate play for Lexington to hold on to it. These guys, I think, would be thrilled to get on the board today against this Rocket D. That big defensive line that's been pushing back Lexington all day long. It's going to be a handoff up the middle. Nice play, number 12. He bowls through, so a nice little hole made there, and he gets it down to probably the 2-yard line. It's going to be third and goal. Rockets stacking 6 in the box here. We talked about, it's actually a 2-minute warning right now. It's just 34 seconds on the clock. We talked about that, Brian. So there's plenty of time left here. It's a pitch left. Oh, pursuit by Damari, and he does a great move to get past Damari. Number 12 with a juke. Damari came through the hole, and Lexington's in for the score. So one huge play changed the whole course of this game right now with what is really just under 2 minutes ago. It says 24 seconds here, so we can't be trusting the game clock right now. We don't know if Lexington has a kicker. They certainly could use one here for 2 points, but we'll see what they come up with. Looks like they're going to go for one here. Probably don't have a kick in their arsenal. Oh, it's going to be a pass. Oh, he's looking to pass. Oh, he gets rid of it. Beautiful play right there. Oh, look at this. They're throwing the ball around now. Wow. He did a nice play to shovel that pass, and Damari all over him, number 44, Dan Junta over there. So nice play to stop the extra point, and that's a big stop too because there's no 9-point touchdowns in this league. That could wrap up the game for Reading, but, you know, Reading, they played a nice game here today, certainly the better team, but, you know, a lot of mistakes out there, right, that they can learn from. And you'd rather learn from those mistakes during a win than have it cost you. So Redding's got to shore up a little bit. Maybe it's really just about the momentum, the offensive momentum. It's really only one big play that hurt them at the end. But getting inside the red zone has been a problem for Redding to convert today, and a couple of costly turnovers. And turnovers will kill you every time. So I'm sure the coach is going to be talking to these boys about protecting the ball, especially when it's on the line in the red zone. All right, Lexington set to kick off here. Barboza and Damari back deep. Look for something maybe on sides. They try a little bit. It goes over the head. It's going to go out of bounds, which ends up being a flag, and they'll move that thing back. It's actually a great kick, but a little too much mustard on it, and kick it out of bounds. It's going to be an extra yards for the Rockets. And it's going to be first and 10 here for the Rockets. They're basically going to run out the clock here, I think. The Rockets are going to steal their first victory of the year They did look good. They had a lot of guys who can run the ball offensively. But like you said, it's one of those things about converting in the red zone, and I'm sure the coaches will be all over these guys coming up. So Rockets are going to take over first and 10 here with just a few ticks of the clock left. Rockets going to be content to take a knee right here and run the clock out. And you see that, you hear the referees tell that to the Lexington side too, so I don't think they want these guys getting hurt. You see the guys not even line up on the other side, so probably that's something new I've seen, Brian. They say they're going to take a knee and they're not really going to try to push through. They don't want to get these guys hurt. They have them stand up, they'll let them take the knee and run the clock out. Harrigan under center. Waiting for it to go down to the end. And that's going to do it if they take one more here now. Great first win of the season here for the Rockets. Got some things they can improve on, but this was clearly a team that overmatched Lexington, even though the score wouldn't indicate it. 15-6 will be the final. Felt like 40-6, didn't it, Bri?
No.
Oh, boy, here's the A squad right here. They're coming in. Adam Lee Hooker, Josh Blumenschein. These guys are the best. The A team, the actual A team is here. I told BVH to bring his A game to the B game, if you know what I mean. But great win for the Rockets here. That's a couple wins in a row for the C team and the B team. The E team won earlier 20-6. D team took it on the chin 13-0. But I'm going to pass it off to the A squad here. I tell you, here's a little insight for the A squad. I saw the Chelsea team coming in, and our B team looked like they were twice as big as them. So I'm not feeling real good about their prospects looking at the goons over in the A team.
Well, I kind of like the multiple uniform motifs they've got going on in Chelsea.
Yeah, yeah.
Some black. You never know what you
use. Well, I'll tell you, it's I think the A team, at least by size-wise, we can check off that the advantage on the Reading Rockets. But we'll sign off for now. I'm going to pass it over.